Hello everyone, welcome to another little equipment video. I wanted to do an update on the small rig L bracket, which I'm using for the Canon R5 for roughly a year now, or not a year yet, so the camera isn't out that long yet, but at least 9 months. So I've received some questions about it, about stability, and also gotten feedback from other people using this R bracket. So I want to address some of those questions while I'm here at a campsite in Brittany. So currently blue skies, not much photography. So I thought I'd do this quick video. So first of all, I've been using this R bracket, which I got for 20 or 30 bucks right when it came out, for many months now. I've taken thousands of photos using it, and yeah, stability-wise, for my setup, it works great. I haven't had any issues, neither in the horizontal nor in the vertical position. But I've also done a little modification, which I want to show you and which I think is important for the vertical position. Because this side here, this part of the L bracket, there's a little gap here between the L bracket and the body of the camera normally. So what I've done, I've wrapped this upper part with duct tape a few times, so now it presses against the body of the camera, which gives it a little added strength, so there is no vibration in this direction, which you would have if you wouldn't fill this gap here. Also, the vibration in this direction is much less than without it. Otherwise, there is a little flex to it, and I'm not sure how it is with other brackets. I assume the RRS brackets are a little stiffer from the material, but as I said, I didn't have any problems even with long exposures. I didn't see any vibrations leading to blurry photos. So this modification, very simple to do, gives it additional strength. Now, a very important thing about this R bracket, as the others for the R5, there's a gap here which is needed to move the tilty screen. If you're using a tripod with a screw plate at the top, which I'm using, and also as a second precondition, which is more than 4 centimeters in width. So I'd recommend, what do I have here? I have roughly 5, so 4.5 centimeters, I think, is sufficient to get this very stable, because you can screw it to really hold firm. If you have just a very small plate, which is maybe 3.5 centimeters, which I got feedback from another photographer who has such a plate, you'll not get this stable, because this just bends in, because you're just covering a very small part of the L bracket on both sides here. And if you want to clip it in even, so it didn't even have a screw, so combine it, a small plate here with just 3.5 or less than 4 centimeters with a quick release plate, then you have trouble fitting this or fixing this in the vertical frame. So in that case, I'm not sure if this is the right L bracket. Also, I don't know how others would work, because all the others, they have a similar design. They also have this gap. So the only way this would work, if it's really to the millimeter or less than a millimeter, fitting your plate, and also very stiff material. Other than that, if you have, like I have, a screw plate which is more than 4 centimeters or 4.5 centimeters wide, I don't think you would have any problems using this plate. Otherwise, do your own research. If you have a very small plate with a quick release, I'm not sure if it will hold. You need to ask some others who have this setup to get the feedback. Okay, so that's again my experience. I hope this answers some of your questions. I think this plate, by now it's a little more expensive than I got it, but I think it's still a bargain compared to some others. And if you have the setup similar to mine, I think it's a good choice still. Okay, that's it. I hope you liked this video. If so, leave a thumbs up, and see you in the next one. Bye.